Hey gents, what's going on? It's Maverick here with the first actual Arma 3 Alpha gameplay, or pretty much just an introduction about what the Alpha is. I made a video last weekend about what we can expect, and now that I finally get a look at it, I gotta say I'm pretty happy so far. I had problems actually purchasing the game on the March 5th, as you probably know. The BIS store was down, and I wanted the supporter edition, so I could not buy it from Steam, you know, one of the other packages. So I had to wait, and by the time the website was up and running again, it was like 11 p.m. And yeah, I downloaded it. It was on for about a half an hour, but it was too late to make a video. So I'm gonna do multiple videos on the subject. I'm not gonna do like extended tutorials because this Lexi from Shack Tactical, he apparently had early access to the game, and he made excellent tutorials about the new features. I'm gonna link his channel in the description if you wanna check them out, or maybe you have already seen them. But really outstanding work from him, and I'm not gonna do like redo the whole thing, you know. Okay, I'm just gonna introduce you guys to the Alpha real quick and show you guys what's in it, and then I'm gonna go online or on a map or on a mission real quick, and that's about it for the first video. So let's get into it. Yeah, you see here welcome message, blah blah blah. Then you get main menu. You can go to play, editor options, field manual, exit field manual. It's like gives you some information and some controls, so you might want to give that a quick read because there's not an actual tutorial mission as there usually is in the full game. And the controls have quite changed a bit from Arma 2 to this game right here. I really like those changes, but my fingers and my head is so into Arma 2 after all those years, it's gonna take me a while to get used to it. But I'm pretty sure that once you're used to it, it's a lot of fun, and it's extremely great. So you might want to give that a read. Options, you get apparently pretty much all the options that you would have in a full version of the game. You can change your video settings, very detailed. Just FYI, I'm playing on pretty much maximum settings. I hope the full game is not going to be requiring you know, a higher set of specs than this Alpha version right here, because then I'm extremely happy. Yeah, that's where you can do your overall chances. You see a very high ultra, very high ultra, high blah blah blah. So I'm pretty good with my new system. Audio controls, then the regular controls, you might want to give that a read as well, and rebind the keys the way you like. Game settings, you can enable, disable subtitles and all that. You can change difficulty settings. I'm gonna go into that later, you know, not on the video, but just for me, and remove all the hot stuff and the friendly markers and the crosshairs and all that stuff, because yeah, in my opinion, it has nothing to do in a tactical simulator such as Arma. So I'm gonna remove that for me personally. Then you get your profile settings. Also here, pretty much as in Arma 2, you wanna create your own profile. You can name it, you can select the face, you can select glasses if you want. You can select a you know, a speaker. Here's you get access to your player ID. That might be necessary for some additional stuff later, especially squad URL. So that's pretty basic right here. Expansions, probably the same as in Arma 2. So here you could create your mod folders, or you create your mod folders in the safe, in the main directory, and then you can load or enable, disable them from right here. Arma 3 Alpha modding is enabled, so all the whole modding community out there is already. Or has already access to those things, and I guess some of them have already started to create their own add-ons and mods. So I'm really looking forward to it. So I guess you don't have to wait to the release of the full game until you can download some free add-ons and play them with this Alpha version already. Yeah, it's about that. Editor. You see, I'm going from bottom to top, doesn't matter. You can just select one map right here. Go continue. Mission editing. Yeah, this is probably the thing where I'm gonna spend most of my time with Peter's year in the alpha version or also in the full game. Has always been that way for me. It looks a bit different. I actually already changed yesterday. I'm not sure how I did it, but the new layout looks a bit different. Ah, there it is. Streamlined. So this is like the new layout. Come on. I gotta restart. So this is the new layout. You got pretty much the same stuff as before, but it looks a bit different. So if you want to use that, feel free. If you want to change it, choose your optional. Go to traditional, then it's pretty much as it was in Arma 2 and Arma 1. So it looks a little bit different with those symbols up here, but you get those all those groups and all that, as you probably used to from Arma 2. So yeah, editor works the same way. You pretty much place your cursor somewhere on the map, double click, and you get to the unit insert window. We can start creating units, spawn them on the map, all the same. If you go to groups, you can spawn groups, triggers, waypoints, synchronize markers, modules. I have not really checked it out yet and don't know if pretty much all the stuff is available already, you know, with triggers and waypoints. So if you're going to be able to create your full-scale missions, I cannot tell you that yet. I know from units there's just a limited selection in the alpha version, obviously. Also here in the missions that come with the version, not all the vehicles are included. So if you want to try different stuff and just have your time and maybe just drive around a bit on this beautiful island, you may want to do that in the editor. Very simple, double click, go to blue 4 or up 4, then select class, cars, ship, air if you want to do some flying. And yeah, spawn that stuff, and you get all the time you want to test it out. So that's all for the editor. Pretty straightforward, and thank God it's like similar to the Arma 2 game and Arma 1 as well. Because if they created a whole new thing, me and a lot of other people would pretty much have to start from scratch with the mission editing. So I'm glad I can pretty much use the knowledge I already got and hopefully integrate it in Arma 3. Alright, if you go to play here, this is where you can actually have some fun right away. You get showcases. Those are four smaller missions. You get an infantry showcase, which is like an infantry combat situation. You can check out the scuba, so the submariner stuff. You can go to a vehicle showcase. And you can go to a helicopter showcase. You see, I've already or just checked out the first one. So this is pretty cool. Small missions where you can familiarize yourself with the content or with the changes from Arma 2 to Arma 3. And you don't get any challenges here. I'm not sure what that is. And you get multiplayer access. So I guess all those servers are probably going to be private servers. I don't think there's already hosted ones. Or I mean like dedicated ones, so probably just a few friends playing together. I'm not sure though. No, we already got one with 30 players, so there are already dedicated servers out there. But this is pretty cool. If you go to new and then host, you can create yourself something and play it with your friends in a private map. Alright, in this next part I'm gonna hop on the map with just a small, very small showcase I created in the mission editor, so nothing fancy, but I just want to give you a first impression about how the game, or how the alpha version looks, and a few of the major features. Okay, so this is how the Arma 3 alpha looks in game. It already looks pretty cool, and yeah, it's very detailed, the terrain is nice, the lighting is very cool. But if you take a closer look, you can definitely see that it's not super polished yet. But yeah, it's an alpha version, so don't be pissed about that, or don't start commenting the graphics sucks and shit. I mean, it's an alpha version, and I'm sure Bohemia Interactive will polish up those graphics till the final release. but it already looks pretty nice now, and it will look even better once the game comes out, I'm sure. Now, okay, for the basic thing, Arma is still Arma. That's, I guess, the most important thing to all the long-time players and to the community. It has not become some sort of shooter, you know, like Battlefield or I don't know, I'm not going to compare it to Call of Duty, but, you know, a lot of games, a lot of series have become those run-and-gun, fast-paced action shooters. And Arma did not. Arma sticks to its roots, and that's what I like about it. I did not really expect anything else, but I'm just saying. Also here, for me personally, very important, TrackIR is supported already in the alpha version, so I can use my TrackIR to look around and all that. Because I'm so used to it, I would be lost without it. Yeah, I'm not gonna do like extended information here on stances and stuff. The whole player controls are quite a bit different than from the previous titles. If you do have problems, watch Dyslexis tutorials. He made some already on Monday, I think, so even before the release, he had early access to the game apparently, and he did outstanding work on those videos. So if you got problems, check them out. I'm gonna link his channel in the description. All right, so yeah, quite a bit changes here in the player controls and in the moving control stances and paces and all that. Now vehicles, let's just see. I've not really checked out the vehicles yet. So if you look around in the vehicles, first things that personally comes to mind is the mirrors. If I move now, you can see the mirrors, the rearview mirrors, they actually work. So that's pretty sweet. That's something that was never possible in Arma 2 or Arma 1. The resolution is crappy, so it's very pixely. I hope that's going to be polished as well. But at least you can see where you're driving, because in Arma 1, if you were playing first person view, you could not see where you're driving. And you even got a rear view camera. So that's pretty damn sweet. Also here you get a lot more details, like, you know, the hands moving on the steering wheel, all those displays and stuff. I guess they're really working. It seems that the HUD, you know, is reduced to a minimum, and that's something I already hated in the previous titles. You had so much HUD information, and especially if you record videos and stuff, it's just, it looks crappy, you know. And in Arma 3, the HUD is really reduced. It's created there on the top left. You still get pretty much the same information, you know, with the health status of the vehicle, if you can, know the damage status actually, the speed and stuff. On the right, you get the selected weapon. But other than that, it's a lot better integrated in the whole display. You know, you don't get like the whole top area filled with HUD information, so that's something I love very much. I can't tell you very much about the physics yet. I'm just driving around a bit here. It's definitely different than Arma 2. A lot more realistic. Also the sound pack is pretty nice. I always hated the sound pack on the original Arma 1 or 2 game, so I pretty much played from or with the sound mod when the first one came out. But already here, I'm not even sure what it is. It's a 50 cal machine gun. Sounds pretty nice to me. Let's see the gunner view. Oh, gunner seat. Already here, you can use the inside vehicle view. I can look around with my TrackIR, and at the same time, I can operate the gun, and I get the actual image here on that display. So I don't have to go into a zoom in. I can go into the zoom in up, obviously. I'll probably use like a flare and all that, but I don't have to. So I can still look around, I can see outside the vehicle, and I can move my gun, and I can freaking engage. I mean, if that's not cool, then what is? Alright. It's not bow. Another thing that is very cool, yeah, I'm not near a building now, but the grenade throwing has changed a lot. You gotta be careful though, because if you throw them not far enough, they might hurt you. So the whole grenade throwing and the grenade physics, they have changed a lot. So it's now actually, possible to hit a freaking door in a building, because before it was always touch and go if you tried to throw a grenade into a building. But now you can pretty accurately aim with them. You can do like wall bounces and all that stuff. So that's very neat. I'm not gonna go into flying now, so as I said, this was pretty much just to give you a first impression. Watch this Lexus tutorials for detailed information on different things. And just stay tuned, I'm gonna upload more Armor 2 footage for sure. Also some multiplayer footage, I guess. But I'm not gonna do like extended tutorials or whatever, because there's already a lot of stuff online. But thanks a lot for watching, and catch you guys soon. Maverick.